Give a man a fish, and he will eat for a day. Teach a man to fish, and he will eat for the rest of his life. Teach a woman how to be happily married, and everyone will eat, sleep, and be merry. It's time for Real Women, Their Ups and Downs, and Life Confessions here on the Happily Married Wives broadcast. Real Women, Their Ups and Downs, and Life Confessions.
Excellent. I am so excited. I am Louidajean LJ Holloway Payton.
And I'm Latisha M. We are the hosts of tonight's show. Louidajean, just so excited to be here with you. Out of everybody who I can be partnered with, I am partnered with probably the most excitable, the biggest smiling lady that we have in the whole program. So I'm super excited to be here with you tonight. But I know, you know, this is coming up to, we are, you know, getting into the Christmas holiday soon. And
yes,
we're super excited. So tell us any exciting news that you or your family have done this week.
Well, you know what, Latisha, it is never a boring day moment in the household, Payton. And so just to let you know, all last week was studying, knocking it down. For insurance tests, my kids was finishing up with, you know, finals, and it was just crazy. And then we had a war banquet on Sunday, and then mommy did her thing and passed her test on Monday. Whoop whoop! So,
congratulations!
So when
congratulations, I you know what, those tests are not easy.
No, not at all. And you know what? Let me tell y'all that's listening. I was praying up some stuff. Holy God, I know people thought, okay, is she crazy? What's going on up in the joint? You know what I'm saying? Right before they lock you in the room and you can't do nothing for like 2 hours and 40 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
But it was just an overwhelming feeling just to say that. So I'm excited. And then, Latisha, come on now. Tell me what's going on with the networking that you got happening and everything on the radio end of it.
Oh, absolutely fabulous things. You know, we always get inquiries for new shows, and we always get people who think radio, what we do, is so easy. They don't realize the hard work, the, you know, the fact that you can't just come on and do a show. I love people who want to just come on and ramble. No, let's get that together. I've been working with some really great hosts and really formulating what they want to convey to their audience. We don't do scripted shows here, but you better have a great outline. And we have some amazing shows. Like, we have one that started a couple of weeks ago. They were already doing their show on a FM station in Virginia, but that station closed down. So they were like, listen, we're knocking on your doors. You're the best thing that happened in this area. And so
awesome. It's
called Pizza Money and Sarcasm. I don't know how many of our happily married wives want to go over and check them out because they are very off the chain.
But
the one of the owners owns a chain of pizzerias, and another one actually owns a finance school where for serious entrepreneurs, and I know we deal with a lot of women who are entrepreneurs on this brand as well.
Yes.
They teach you how to make and save money for free. Mm. They just ask you to do a donation to the Make-A-Wish Foundation.
Really?
Yes. But if you're trying to make a business out of what they do, then that's when, you know, you have to pay. And guess what? Most of it is just paying for your own licenses and fees. They still don't charge you at the school itself. So you don't have to be in Virginia. You can be anywhere because they have online classes. And the beauty part of it is it's about it's really about just educating people on how to save for their lives. You know, you would be surprised how many people don't have life insurance plans or savings plans and things like that. And if things unexpected happen, if you lose a loved one, if you are the loved one who's lost and you don't have a game plan in place for your family. So check them out, you know, the guys from – but – as great as all of that sound, that is not what they talk about. That's not what they talk about.
Girl,
I know, right? I stole the mess out of them. if that was all based on what they do professionally. What they
yes.
do on radio is shenanigans and nonsense. But it's funny.
Yeah.
We have a lot of new shows coming out that will be funny, that will be serious, that will be prayerful. You'll be able to get the spirituality that you need. You'll be able to have a
yes.
good chuckle, and you'll be able to learn from some really great, powerful people. So, you know, definitely continue to check out what Maybe Help You Radio Network is doing. So thank you so much for asking. But I know, you know, just thinking of you said your kids were taking finals. Man, what is it like having this, like, adult in your house now? You know what I mean? Like, you know, they went from this is my baby to – man, I need this kid need to start paying some bills around here.
Well, I will share this with you all. It's one of those things my mom told me and my grandma, because that's the household I grew up with, was that my job at that point in time was school.
Mm-hmm.
And if I wanted to do an outside activity, obviously it was that, whatever I was doing at the church. And, you know, just doing my best and performing my best.
Absolutely.
And that's all they requested. That's all they requested. Now, you know, I told my son, you know, I got two boys and a baby girl. I said, you know, now y'all adding on bills, right? You know,
mm-hmm.
y'all talking about cell phone bills, and, you know, you got the iPad. That's still a bill if you wanted to work on the network. You know?
Girl,
and so,
you better tell them.
You know, I'm sharing with them that it's a different time. So with that, they still have the same responsibilities. But we have to get them to understand that even though mommy and daddy may not be putting money in your hand, oh, every month money is flowing
mm-hmm.
on your behalf. Just saying.
You know, and I'm glad that you're teaching them those lessons, because one of the things that I think is disconnect from some of our teenagers now, and I hope that some of the mothers who are listening to the program can kind of relate to what I'm about to say, is that the generation that's going up now, before – and you know, probably the last four generations don't understand the value of a dollar.
Yeah, yeah.
Because you just said it, with the way that technology has trended since AOL, since dial-up, that
Come
has
on.
Always, you know, it was something that was added that was an extra cost. Once they
yeah.
came up with the first triple play, that was
mm-hmm.
something that was added that was an extra cost. We were never paying, you know, our parents were never paying that amount of money for phone, TV, and there, you know, and there was no internet service. So, you know,
now, let's
so,
keep real. Let's keep
yeah.
real. Don't you remember, you used to go through the grocery store and they'd have the little free CDs. Oh yeah, just get your internet.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. You know what I mean? So, and even taking it even higher, let's even look at the fact that the amount of channels that we have on our cable. I'm, you know, sometimes I'm appreciative. I mean, ever since I started running a network, I don't even know what TV is half the time. I have to do what's called binge watching. All of y'all know about it.
Right.
And that's another expense. That's why you get Hulu. But,
right.
But, I mean, you know, when you think about it, the most we had that was extra on our TV was like HBO and Showtime. You
well,
know, and so everybody had the same level of type of cable except for if you had those premium channels. Now they have like 10 different packages for TV. You know, they have this, they have that. So like you said, just maintaining the household so that we're all comfortable and happily entertained
yes.
has to be enough. When is enough enough? And speaking of that, I mean, I know that everybody is ready for us to dive into this program. Are you excited about tonight's show?
Oh, girl, you know it. Come on now.
I'm loving it. I'm loving it. Well, let's tell you guys what's going to go on tonight. So you definitely are going to be poured into by the two women who are enjoying your company as well. And don't forget, throughout the program, you can visit our Facebook page and tell us what you like, or tweet to us. Tweet to us at HappilyMarriedW and tell us what you think about the show. Any quotes, we love to hear from you. But I am going to be telling you today that are you a runaway bride? I want to see the signs that you are losing your identity.
That's good.
What about you, LJ?
Well, you know, I talked earlier initially about the roller coaster. So we got to step it off with step right up. So
I'm now. Ooh, let me tell you, that roller coaster conversation that we had, I should actually go get that clip one day and play it during one of our shows. It was really good, ladies. If you missed it, go back to the premiere show where you can hear the interview I did with LJ, and it was amazing. But, guys, you know what? We have to take a quick commercial break, but we are going to be coming back up with Are You a Runaway Bride? Signs That You Are Losing Your Identity. So stay tuned. Don't go anywhere. We want you to love up our sponsors now. They're paying for this show. We'll be right back.
Did you know that 1 in 4 people in America live with a mental illness? Do you have the communication skills to help out if one is in a crisis? What if it's your best friend? Maybe your son or daughter? While crisis intervention isn't new, the book Crisis Intervention 101 is. It's easy to read, includes links to 2 videos, and it's under $10. Get your copy of Crisis Intervention 101 today on Amazon.com, because we all need help in a crisis.
Hi, I'm Rita Ricks, host of Spirit Journeys Radio, inviting you to our 3rd annual Burn on December 27th from 4 to 6 o'clock p.m. We'll work together to determine what person, place, or thing you must leave behind in 2015. You'll write your choices on a piece of paper and drop them in the fire so that you can enter the new year brand new. The cost is $10, and you can register at www.speaktoyourspirit.com. See you on December 27th.
In a fast-paced world, getting your message heard everywhere can still be a challenge if you're not connecting to your target audience. Allow MWHY Radio to assist you in getting your message heard on social media, video, digital magazines, on apps, and on our broadcast network. MWHY Radio's broadcast listeners tune in online through 10 terrestrial stations on iHeartRadio and during live events. Visit our Fiverr page for special offers throughout the summer to assist you in jumpstarting your advertising needs. That's www.fiverr.com/MWHY Radio. FIVERR.com/MWHY Radio.
All right. Well, ladies, we're excited. And gentlemen, I'm sorry, it's going to be some gentlemen listening tonight. We're so excited to welcome you back to Happily Married Wives Radio Show with, you know, LJ, Louidajean Holloway Payton, and
Latisha M., host of tonight's show. We're so excited.
Well, you know, I'm glad that you all have joined us tonight. And, you know, before we took our commercial break, we kind of told you a little bit about our segments that we've got going on. And so I'm so excited about that. So Latisha, take us away.
Absolutely. You know, when we were thinking about what we were going to talk about to the women, and because especially the first couple of weeks, we want to breathe new life into your marriage. And I was just thinking about some of the women who do what's called emotional cloaking. Emotional cloaking is when you meet a partner that you like, and you like that person so much that you want to take on their personality, their likes, their fears, their favorite color. You want to root for the same sports team. You kind of lose your identity. Now, when we think about the movie Runaway Bride, and that's where I got my title from, the character that was played by Julia Roberts, she dated 3 men who she took up to the seat of engagement, all the way to a wedding date, all the way to almost getting married.
Right.
And in each situation, things that make up who we are, she changed herself to be what that person liked. So if that person was sophisticated, she took on a more sophisticated role in her own life. She chose her eggs to be one way. She did this, she did that. But then by the time she moved on to the next person, her whole personality changed. She was more of a wild girl. She was more free-spirited. She did the same, everything that that one person did, because it was something that she liked in that person, she started to do it because she thought that would make the person like her more. Mm. And when you do that, you find that you're losing yourself. Let me ask you a question, LJ.
Yeah.
Now, you know, just thinking of how many years we have both been on this earth, and I know that this has happened to you. Have you had a girlfriend who every time she got into a relationship, you don't even hear from her no more? The only time you hear from her is when something's going wrong in her relationship, the relationship is about to end, or something so dramatic has happened, she's pregnant, she's this, she's that, then that's when you start kind of seeing her a little bit more and hearing about her a little bit more?
Girl, what did you say that? That's an understatement. Bottom line, that's an understatement. It's so funny because you're like, okay, she done kicked us to the curb again.
It did. You said, come on. But you expect it. After the first two times it has happened,
It's a wrap, right? So she kicked you to the curb, and then when she called you, it's almost like she's stalking you, right? Because you're like, no, you kicked her to the curb, now you want to stalk me for my advice or so you can have somebody to do woe with me on. And girl, it's funny. I'm going to leave it at that because if I talk too much, I might slip and say some names, you know.
Oh, Lord, we don't want no names. The words that are said on this program are not supported by the MWHY Radio Network.
Definitely.
All right, so legal stuff out the way. I actually had a gentleman guest in my studio last night while we were doing a couple of other shows. His brand is running some marketing things to me. He's a younger guy. I love talking to the youth, I got to tell you. And I'm not an old girl yet myself. I'm getting there. But it tickles me to talk to these 20-something-year-olds. So he said to me, you know, he was in his woe's me phase. And, ladies, I'm saying this to you because this is coming from a 20-something-year-old man.
Come on.
He said to me that he was sad that him and the girl that he was seeing would no longer be seeing each other. And he even asked her if they could be friends, and she said no. So I said to him, why didn't you fight harder for this relationship? It sounded like she was really pouring her heart out to you. And he told her he didn't have a lot of time for her. He's a musician, and he said, I can't just stop everything I'm doing every time you want to have a conversation. He was being real, but he wasn't being mean. But this is why he decided not to fight to secure this relationship that had only been going on for a few months. He said because Latisha, she was trying to change everything who she was to be the perfect type of person for me, and that's never what I wanted her to do.
Wow.
She's in college. He's a musician. She was missing classes. She was asking him what his favorite sports team was. She never watched hockey before. Now she's calling him about the hockey games. You know, she was so busy trying to be who he was and what she thought would make him happy and satisfied because she wanted him to spend more time with her, that she didn't realize it wasn't that he couldn't spend time with her because he didn't like her. They're in the studio right now recording their album. And he kept trying to tell her, this is the battle of being a musician. Sometimes I have to cut off my right arm so that my left arm can be free for this moment. It doesn't mean I'm cheating on you. It doesn't mean I lost interest in you. You know, I can talk to you at night when I can, but I can't always drop what I'm doing. So what is it about women that sometimes, it's more common in women. I'm not saying that men don't do it too. Men, you are guilty of this. But what is it about us that we feel as though if I become what that person is, then I can, that best friend mode will automatically kick in and our relationship would be stronger. Didn't they like you because of your differences when they first met you?
Well,
you know, these are the things that some people, I think, don't really consider. They don't really think about. It's the things that make us different. Now, I'm going to say this, too, from a counselor standpoint. If you are with somebody who is trying to make you emotionally who they are, like what they like, do what they do, that is not a healthy relationship.
Mm.
There are many forms of abuse, and that is considered mental abuse.
Come on now.
That person is not fulfilled until you are who they want you to be. Have you ever been with a man and he says, I mean, I like your long hair, but I wonder what it would look like short? That's an emotional mind game. He likes short hair women, and so he wants you to be that.
That's good.
I like you this, but I think you could stand to lose a few pounds. Why don't we start working out together? If you're not stepping up to me about losing weight for a health reason, you need to step off. You better love me for me.
Well, come on.
So, come on. You know, we have to think about these things. How can you be a happy wife if you are suppressing the true person who you are? It will come out. It may not be 5 years. It may not be 10 years. But once you've had those kids and they've left the house and it's just you and your husband again, and you don't have your own identity that to cling to, your own hobbies, your own likes, depression is going to kick in. Possible separation and divorce, because you're now going to not be satisfied after so many years. God forbid something happens to your husband. You're going to be that widow that can never remarry because you were never your own person.
Yeah.
We have to shed these emotional cloaks that we put on ourselves sometimes just to satisfy even our husbands. Like I said, you know, for anyone who's out there who's a newlywed, shed that emotional cloak. Girl, newlywed life is the bomb.
Come on.
The longer you can keep that newlywed fire going.
Yeah.
I don't know about you, LJ, but my husband bought me a new gift. I don't know what I laid on that man, but I'm thanking Jesus for giving it to me.
Well, come on.
I got a new gift for the first 2 weeks.
We got kids listening. Come on now.
But I'm telling you, I got a new gift every day for 2 weeks after we got married.
Come on. I'm mad.
You know, we still remained my best friend, he is to this day.
Yeah.
But we have a lot of similar interests. And, yeah, there's things that I didn't know about that I learned from him and I liked. But the things that I liked before, I still like them. The things that
right.
he liked before, he still likes them. We accepted each other for who we were before we created a union.
Right, right.
And,
definitely,
you know, and so those. So here are some points, and I want your advice on these points. That you can use to recognize if you are losing your identity. We don't want you to turn into a runaway bride. So, you know, what makes you different than anyone else that has ever been in his life? What are some of the key things that he found interesting in you? Because I know you had that late night conversation. We all did. Why you like me? What is it about you like me? Go back. Some of y'all have to go back further than others. Some of us can go back a couple of years, but some of us got to go back like 20 years and think about that conversation. And for some people who wear emotional cloaks, we may ask that question more times than others. But what is it that your spouse, your boyfriend, your soon-to-be husband says to you that he says, I like you because, or, you know, it's because you do this. It's because of that. Those things that make you different and unique, keep them up. So what do you think? What makes you different, LJ, than you think has ever been in your husband's life before you?
Ooh, I got to hit it hard. And, again, it can go good and bad, just saying. But the dynamics that I came with who I was.
Mm-hmm.
And it didn't really matter what he said, what he didn't say. If he told me he liked something or he didn't like it, I was gonna wear it. I was gonna do it. And so I think it was just because he couldn't put me in the peg hole.
There you go.
Yeah.
There you go. It's I love that. That's what your husband loves about you. I think what makes me different and what made me different in my husband's eyes. Was I came from a family of entrepreneurs, so I'm a dreamer.
Ah.
But unlike most people who are dreamers, a true entrepreneur sees their dreams out to fruition, even if it's
Come
a
on.
Failure.
Yeah.
You know, so and I'm a person of the people. So I'm always trying to figure out, if I can do this, how can I make it work where I can teach it to others? Or how can I give it to somebody else almost for free? So,
oh,
you know,
good.
So those are the kind of things that I think my husband, he loves volunteer work. He loves those things. So those were things that he loved about me. Now,
uh-huh.
I got another one for you.
All right.
What do you do for your own sanity? Because, and the reason why this is important, especially, come on now, our married wives out here, we already know what the saying is, happy wife, happy what?
Come on.
Happy life. So, you know, we want to make sure that you're doing something for your sanity. So what do you do to keep your sanity in the Payton household?
You know, the biggest thing for me is I'm involved in a lot of different organizations that are just female geared. So meaning that I've got my sorority from college and I've got a non-philanthropic sorority, right? And so the dynamics, and then obviously things at church, but the dynamics of being able to have those outlets where you can still be sister girl if you need to, you can still feel like you helping out in the community, and obviously at church being able to make that difference and playing those important roles and just kind of growing your faith as well. And so that keeps me sane. If my husband shut down any of those, I don't know how I would be able to operate.
Absolutely.
I just don't know. Yeah. Yeah.
I love the fact that you said that last part, because that's going into my next point, too. Emotional cloaks don't work just one way. They do work two ways. Your husband can become so codependent on you always being there that when you do start to spread your wings and join organizations and hanging out with the girls, you know, and not in a bad way, but just having girl time sometime. My sister-in-law, they do things every 3 months because her girlfriends have spread out. So every 3 months they make sure they get together, and then once a year they take a small vacation together. They, you know, it's best friends week. And so, you know, they make sure that, and it's like seven of them, you know, and they've been friends most of them since high school or even since middle school, you know. So they, you know, are very close together. But when you do things like that, does your husband have separation anxiety? So here's the next point, ladies. Are you giving him enough space, and what is he doing with his time? I noticed, you know, me and my husband, we did go to high school together. We don't have one of those fairy tales that we dated in high school and then ended up together, but we were very close friends. He could always be at my house. I had the guy house because I had the basketball court in my backyard, so it was all. But I had a clean yard because that was our agreement. Y'all gonna play back here. Y'all the ones that's gonna get these leaves up and do this and do that. And they had no problem with it, you know.
Right.
And my grandmother fed them, so we was all good. But you know, you want to make sure that your man is doing something. So when I noticed, especially when I started taking what I do in my career to the next level, I wasn't able to spend as much time with my husband, because when you work a 9-to-5, by 6 o'clock, where are you? Home. When you're an entrepreneur, 6 o'clock sometimes don't exist.
Well, come on.
You know, so I had to tell my husband, get back into programs. Get back with some friends that you used to hang out with. Start creating back your own. Take back your own life. I am the love of your life, but I cannot be your live all tell all.
Yeah, yeah.
Now, you may not be able to say it to your husband like that, but I'm from up north. LJ know what I'm talking about, so sometimes I'm a little bit more blunt. And I can tell you now, I am not the emotional one in the relationship, so sometimes, you know, when we were talking about in the premiere show, those lessons of being silent do come in handy. Again, hint, hint, wink, wink, go back and listen to that premiere show, I'm telling you.
Come on,
but down. One of the things that, you know, I did learn was how to not only make sure that I have my own sanity, but I had to make sure my husband had his.
Yes.
What are you doing, ladies, to make – the couch and TV is not your husband's – it should not be his sanctuary of his personal time. He should, just like we have activities, your husband should have activities too. I'm not saying that we got to make them do something, but find something that you know of interest and start it with them, and then fade yourself out.
Oh, that's good.
To.
Yeah.
Because if you leave this earth tomorrow, you don't want your husband to go years and years and years before he even attempts to try to find another love. You want him to already be out there in the world and not be afraid to get back on the horse. I'm not saying we want him to get on the horse right now and then all of a sudden we divorce. Don't, again, the words that are said on this broadcast. But I really think that when, you know, when you come, now when you come home at the end of the day and you say, so what did you do today? You guys have conversation. Because you have your life at home, and now you have your activities that you can either do together or not. And that's another thing, and that's my last point. You still want to have planned time together, and you want to jump it back and forth between not just things he likes, but things that just you like. Maybe he don't like them too much, but guess what? Every once in a while, just like we make sacrifices for our husbands and everything that they like, they have to make sacrifices for us as well. A lot of women have grown up in an old school fashion way where they sacrifice so much of who they are that they don't even, their husband don't even enjoy what they do, period. That's my wife's thing. I can't even get into that. Okay, that's your wife's thing, but what's wrong with the supporting of it? You don't have to be there every time I'm doing something. You don't have to join me and watch this program every time I'm watching it. You don't have to enjoy going shopping with me every time I go. But the fact that you can on sometimes, it makes that difference. It makes that time special. LJ, how do you and your husband plan time together?
Oh, man. You know what? With all the activities, we make every moment count. And so we've gotten past that, you know, once we had one kid, then we had another, and then 4 years, God said, okay, time for another. And so because of that, we had to realize that the moment counted in the moment that we were in.
Mm-hmm.
So with that being said, I'm just going to make it real simple. We cooking dinner, right? We having fun cooking dinner. Now, did we plan that we were going to cook dinner together? No. It just kind of flows that way. And then, oh, while we're doing it, oh, yeah, babe, let's watch the latest Blackish. So, you know, now it becomes us having a planned activity to, okay, then we're doing it. And then sometimes he'll walk in and he'll be like, oh, man, I want to go fishing. Now, I could easily be like, what? He ain't planning to go no fishing. What are you talking about, right? I don't even go there. I'm just like, okay, yeah, okay, great. Where are we going? You know what I'm saying? So we are really at the point of our lives into just instant planned moments. If that I think it's an oxymoron.
No, and it is. It's one person has an idea in their head, especially if the other one knows, you know, because, you know, if your husband's anything like my husband, he's like, oh, Latisha don't have a show right now. You know, so he's probably thinking, oh, LJ's home and she don't have to go do nothing right now because he knows what your other activities are. And so once that thought pops in his head, you know, my husband will call me, you dressed? No, get dressed. We going out.
Exactly.
You know, so like you said, it's those spontaneous planned moments are wonderful in a marriage, and you have to keep them up. So, ladies, you know, I hope that you took a couple of these points. I love, LJ, that you was able to share and kind of share your experiences with us during this time as well. But you know what time it is. It is, you know, sponsor paying, commercial paying time.
Come on,
Dad. Ain't nothing wrong with that. So, everyone, remember, you are listening to the Happily Married Wives radio broadcast. We are going to take our quick commercial break. Love up our sponsors. Tell us what you're loving about the show right now. Facebook us, tweet us, and we will be right back after this short commercial break.
Are you frustrated, disappointed, discouraged with your life? Are you angry with God? What's holding you back from fulfilling your purpose? Are you struggling as a leader in ministry? Do you believe you have an end time calling? If you answered yes to any of these questions, tune in to The Waymakers on MWHY Radio Network every other Friday at 11 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. We are here to support you. Join us to get the answers that will prepare the way of the Lord in your life.
If you're the parent of a child with behavioral challenges that has been suspended, expelled, or just not able to make it in a traditional school setting, there is an alternative. Call the Metropolitan Day School today. Licensed and accredited grades K through 12. Call 804-321-2595. Financial assistance and after-school programs are available. Let's turn this school year around right now at the Metropolitan Day School, where eagles soar. Call Ms. Thomas today, 804-321-2595.
If you were designing the perfect dating site, what would you include? A private voice or video chat room? A private photo gallery and profile area? How about matches based on similar interests? And to keep it special, you could add profile blocking, no third-party intervention, spam protection, and even monthly drawings for great prizes and more. That's exactly what you'll find at milesapart.dating. Visit milesapart.dating today and get a free one-year membership while they last. That's milesapart.dating.
And welcome back to the Happily Married Wives radio broadcast. I am your host, Latisha M.
And I'm Louidajean LJ Payton.
All right now. And I'm so glad you guys have joined us for tonight. You know, before we went to break, LJ, you know, we kind of dived a little bit into my subject, are you a runaway bride? Signs that you are losing your identity. But you know what now? It is time to flip the switch. So ladies and gentlemen, we are coming up with Louidajean. Miss Louidajean Payton, and I know that you're bringing us an amazing, amazing follow-up to the conversation that we had during the premiere show. So at this time, I am going to let you take it away, darling.
Oh, man. Thank you so much, Latisha. You know, when I started off, I talked about the journey being on that roller coaster, and I kind of wanted to just touch bases on how I even got to that point and how we as women and men are thinking about the union and what it's like. So that's the step right up mentality. Where are we right now? And what was indicative for myself was that I had gotten to a point where I wasn't concerned about who was getting married around me, right? Because, you know, we all get to that point in our 20s where, girl, every other week it seems like you're paying for a dress. Come on now.
A dress and a, what is it, a...
A gift. Come on
A
now.
Gift for a baby. There you go. Baby showers.
Come on now. And so, you know, I was past that 25 mark, and, you know, I'm getting invited, it seemed like, every other week to a baby shower, a wedding. Something was going on. And I had gotten to a point where I said, okay, God, you know what? If it's for me, great. But if not, I think I'm getting to the point where I could just be this career businesswoman, right? And it was interesting because I had settled that in my spirit. And, you know, prior to that, boy, I didn't even want to talk about it. I was dealing with some jokers. You know, I had gone through that. You know, I had to have a rough neck. You know, had to have somebody squeaky clean. No, I mean, just all these different things that were going on with the guys that, you know, I had been dating. And my mom and Graham, they would come visit me, and they'd be like, well, when are we going to meet somebody? You know? And the dynamics was I was like, well, you know, when I'm ready, you'll meet that person.
Mm-hmm.
But right now, they just good enough to take me out to eat. That's it. That's all this. That's it. And so I had gotten to a point where I was okay because, you know, sometimes we go through the blues phase and we get stuck there, right? And then we start running after all what we see, right? And we know the phrase, all that glitter ain't gold. And you can find yourself in a moment of time where it's a slippery slope. So when we're thinking about that stepping right up, you know, Latisha, even for yourself, you know, when did you get to the point where you were comfortable with who you were?
It actually took me a long time. I went through a lot of transitioning because, like you said, through the late 80s and then the early 90s, the trends that were around us were so constantly changing and becoming bolder that as women, it was harder to find what type of woman you wanted to be. Did you want to be a traditional woman? Did you want to be a bold and fierce woman? So it took me a long time. I would say it wasn't until I was probably in my mid-20s that I finally said, this is who I am. Love me or hate me.
Come on. Come on, just saying. And for us, and this is for women and men, before you can step up, right, you got to get to a point where you are okay with just who you are,
who you are.
And I think for, you know, a lot of us, you know, we try to define who we are once we get with somebody, right?
Mm-hmm.
And that's where if you're not strong enough and if you're not using outside sources, whether that's spiritual, I'm a Christian, so I'm leaning on that spiritual piece of it, whether you're getting spiritual counselors or just a regular counselor, that you can get lost and it can get real ugly, right? It can just get real ugly. So the dynamics is that when I got ready to step up, I never felt much just alive. Like it didn't matter anymore, right? You know, I was just doing my thing, flying. My girl said, "Yeah, let's go to the cabana in Toronto." I'm like, "Girl, come on now. We four of us in a Mustang Ford." You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And just road tripping. And so it was a great time to be able to just enjoy. And the dynamic piece of that was that when I did get to the next phase, and that's kind of where I want to gradually go on, because as we're standing in life to get on the roller coaster for the marriage, we're going through the phases. So, you know, I looked at the sign and said, okay, am I above 5'2"? You know, they got the little markers on the little side. And so, okay, I'm meeting all these criteria, conditions, and then I'm ready to go through the gate. And so at that point, when I started to go with different trips, my girlfriends, and just enjoying, and then I got hit with, my mom got diagnosed with breast cancer. Mm-hmm. And I mention this because I know that all of us that have either gone through or are in an emotional state, and it doesn't have to necessarily be a life-threatening disease, right?
Mm-hmm.
It can be a financial, emotional state, right?
Mm-hmm.
It could be going into the next job position.
Mm-hmm.
You know, whether or not I'm going to even go on a master's school or go to college, you know, just life choices, right? That's when I realized that, okay, God, what's Louidajean going to do? What I'm going to do?
Mm-hmm.
And I had a great conversation with my mom. Actually, I was on my way, my girlfriend was getting married up in Detroit. Again, remember I told you I was going to weddings a lot back then. And my mom, she in the hospital, and she going to have a surgery. And she's like, "Well, what you going to come to the hospital for? What can you do for me right now, Louida? What can you do for me?" And my mom, Graham, they've always kept it real. And I said, "You know, Mom, that's right. That's right. I got to think about what I still love you, Mom. There's much love there, but I heard her heart. And it was, I need you to make a choice. Are you going to live or are you going to die?" And my mom said it. She spoke it so clear. She said, "I will always be here for you, regardless of what you might physically see with your eye."
Mm-hmm.
And this is right before she about to be cut. Right?
Mm.
And I'm like, this woman, I'm crying like a baby and all this jazz. And again, that's why I said it's life-changing moments that are happening to us. And are we listening to it when it's time to step up? And so I said, "You know what, Mom? You're right. I'm going to go have a blast at the wedding. I'm going to drive up there and see some girlfriends. We're going to have a ball. And then I'm going to see you regardless, and I'm going to live like I've never lived again." And that was a turning moment for me to step up. And so, you know, Latisha, when you think about that turning moment, did you have a turning moment for you?
Absolutely. I think my turning moment, I got married young, and my now husband was such a friend to me that he came to Georgia and walked my grandmother down the aisle. And the turning moment came when I realized my first marriage was not for me. It wasn't even, it wasn't for my husband. And I had to, the lessons that I learned from that marriage made me the woman I am today. I believe if I would have stayed in New Jersey and stayed around my friends and my family, I probably would have been spoiled, arrogant, and a lot of other, you know, acronyms that define what, you know, the media thinks black women are. That would have been me. I wouldn't have been typical. But I learned to be a selfless person. I love to be a devoted person. And I knew that the next person that I decided to give my heart to would have it, and I would not put any restrictions, any chains, or any abbreviations, you know, a contract near it, because I knew I would give it to the person who deserved it. That was a great, that matured me so much. I'm probably 60 to this day. Because, you know, when you talk to your elders, you can't tell them nothing, and they say whatever they want to say. And that was kind of what happened to me. I became a whole different, I was so much mature than the people around me was crazy.
Yes. Yeah, definitely so. Definitely so. That's so powerful. And so as we, you know, transition through that process, it's one of those where if you don't take the time to realize that you're right there, you miss it, right? Mm-hmm. And that's where I think that, you know, I think about the crossroads, you know, and that's where we are at a point before we get to that next level where we can step right up. And so for me, during that journey process, I'm flying, I'm back and forth, going to visit my sister. She lives in the Chicagoland, and I'm with her, you know, 4th of July weekend. And no. That's right. No, Memorial Day weekend. Girl, I was flying so much, I had to get it right now.
get it right, girl.
Memorial Day weekend, you know. And so I was so hot that I would leave out. My girlfriend would take me to the airport, pick me up on a red eye so I could go right into work. That's how bad I was back then. And so, you know, having a good time. And my sister at the time was getting to go into med school, and engaged to her now husband, who she had dated through high school. And, you know, so she kind of had that, I like the happily married, you know, what we as six-year-olds think is supposed to happen. And, you know, she's looking at me like, okay, Louida, what's up with you? You know, and I just told her, I said, you know what, Lisa, I'm enjoying, right? I'm no longer thinking about who's doing what. Like, it wasn't even bothering. Now, I'm the oldest, right? Now, my sister, we're only 11 and a half months apart. But the bottom line is I'm the older one, and my baby sister is getting married before me.
Mm-hmm.
Come on now. Now, you told her I'm stepping right up, putting ego to the side, feeling good, you know, being in that celebratory atmosphere and letting it go. I had to suck it up, right?
Mm-hmm.
Had to suck it up because that was baby sister, right? I had always done for baby sister, took her money, you know, sometimes from her. You know, well, nothing baby sister was going to do for older sister, but you know where I'm going with that.
I know what you're saying.
It was a time where, because emotionally and spiritually I had grown to that step right up level, I was having a great time. So we looking at dresses and, you know, thinking about who's going to be in the wedding and everything. So I'm kicking it with her, and she's like, okay, well, let's go out. Now, I told you my sister had been connected, right?
Mm-hmm.
So she didn't know where to take us. I said, girl, if you go call one of your sorors to tell us where we about to go, we're going to have some fun. And so we go out, and while I'm out, and again, I have to preface it, my mind was in a different place. And that's why I say for you all that when you get to the point where you're no longer looking, you're no longer going out with the expectation, okay, I'm going to find my man tonight, right? You know, my baby daddy is walking up.
Get it, girl.
I mean, you know where I'm going with this, you know, because at this point, I'm 27, right?
Yeah.
27. So, you know, I got people dropping them like it's hot, boom, 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 all over the place, you know? And I just was cool with it. And so we go out and we're at the club, having a good time, and I see two guys at this club with suits on that look like they was in the wrong spot, just like my sister and I looked like we was in the wrong spot. So I say this to say that God will put an atmosphere around you, right, where the hedge of protection will be so strong, you'll be a fool and not walk up in it.
Tell him, LJ.
Oh, now, and that's exactly what he did for me. He had that hedge so strong that I could only see the guy that God had for me because it was right there. And I didn't even know. Didn't even know. And so let me tell you how, you know, because my game was on back then. Game was on back then. It still is. So don't let the rain fool you now. I can show you what you can do now. But the bottom line is, you know, I'm there. We dressed up. And his boy was looking like, does she know you? Because she looking hard. And I've never done this before. That's why I said I was totally, I know God had it lined up. He had it ordered. And it is with his ordering of our steps on a day-to-day basis that if we are observant and are seeing with our spiritual eyes, we won't keep walking over the blessings that he's putting in front of us, right? Yeah. And so that's why I say that it was a step right up moment because it was an opportunity where I could have, had I been still operating in the flesh, in the, ooh, I had to have the Playboy image. Ooh, I had to have the thuggish, ruggish ball image. Ooh, I had to have, you know, he had to be bulging with muscles and, you know, he had to be 6'9", you know, because I'm a tall myself, you know. I mean, if I had all of these other conditions that he had to meet, I would have missed out.
Yes.
I'd have missed out. You know, and so, you know, because I'm a flip it back to, you know, when you get into that opportunity where you almost miss out because you're conditioned by what the world is saying that you should be looking for, you miss out on the blessing that God is putting right in front of you.
I know that's right. And, you know what, and not even to break into your conversation, but when you had that moment where your normal lineup, your normal list didn't even matter.
Come on.
What did that do? Like, how did that change your life? Like, I just want to hear you tell it. How did that change your life into where you are right now?
Ooh, wow. You know what? It allowed me to, you talked about cloaks earlier. It allowed me to drop my guards that I had to be the dying piece. Mm-hmm. That I had to be the image of perfection. Because with Jared, it didn't matter. And I wasn't used to that. And that's why I say that had I not been in the mindset of allowing God to bless me, I would have, who knows what I'd be dealing with right now. I'll be honest with you. I just don't know. Where I would be, you know, at this point right now, my husband is an awesome provider. You know, he's been providing solely for our home for 13 years. I don't know to this day how that's possible. Hallelujah. I don't know. But with God, I don't know. It's allowed me the opportunity to grow spiritually into the woman that God wanted me always to be in, and I just didn't know that. Not to say that I don't think I was fighting it because I wasn't aware, but I certainly wasn't seeking it either.
Yeah.
You know, and so it allowed me the opportunity where, you know, I was able to grow you know, he transitioned us from living in, you know, Ohio to Indiana, where I had to grow up on what a wife, what a spiritual Proverbs 31 wife needed to actually go into. And I'm at a point right now where I'm going to be real clear. You know, some of y'all, if you ain't seen my picture, I'm natural. I would have never been natural. I'll tell you that right now.
Oh, girl. Who are you telling? Two years going strong.
So, I mean, when I say all of that, I mean, it's just all of that. And so it's just been an exciting time. Now, still a roller coaster. Like I said, I'm going to keep it real. I'm going to keep it 100. But I just wouldn't be, you wouldn't be able to talk to Louidajean right now. You wouldn't be able to talk to me. And so I'm so excited to be in that servant mindset of what God wants me to do right now, which is to relentlessly pursue God's purpose for my life as I continue to draw all women and men unto him. And so now with that, the whole fruition of it, being able to speak to the world, it's just going to be an amazing opportunity. So I'm excited. I'm just at the breakthrough point of the step right up, at the point of now where the next time I'll be able to transition us into the movement, the progressive movement of how I've grown through these years. And so I'm just so excited. It's a blessing. it's hard for me to even fathom what God really has in store. But I'm obedient, and the next, can't wait.
You know what? I'm just so excited for you, and I'm so glad that we were able to hear your story and gain these lessons from you today. Because you know, it's take that moment when you step up from the person who you were to what you said to what God's purpose is for you, who is meant to be in your life, you know,
yes,
and the life that you're meant to lead. So, you know, just thank you so much for sharing today.
Look,
she's so choked up, she can't even get it out, guys. She can't even get it out. Well, you know what? It is that time again. I mean, this time just flies when we are in good company and being able to share. But, everyone, we want you to, you know, just hold your seats. We do have one commercial break. And I know when coming up from the commercial break, we're going to talk about what we learned from the show.
Yeah.
We're going to share the lessons from each other, from what we learned from each other's segment. So, guys, if you want to hear that and you want to learn more, don't go anywhere. Remember, we're on Twitter. We're on Facebook. We want to hear from you. We'll be right back after this commercial break.
Hi, this is Simone Bow of Life Success Principles in Nassau, Bahamas. And I listen to the Ultimate International Business Experience radio show on iHeartRadio. And you should too.
Hi, this is Sylvester Green of Building United Communities here in London, England. And I listen to the Ultimate International Business Experience radio show on iHeartRadio. And you should too.
Have you ever pondered the true meaning of life? Why the world is filled with greed, evil, and corruption? Or if you could truly live forever? The answers to some of these questions are hidden in plain sight and are answered beyond a shadow of a doubt in the new book entitled Wake Up to the World's Best Kept Secrets. Some of the best kept secrets hidden in plain sight. These questions and much more are answered with irrefutable living proof, but more importantly, substantiated with profound biblical scriptural evidence used to support support these eye-opening truths, with a heavy focus on the current state and plight of the so-called African Americans and Black descendants of slaves scattered all around the world. This yet-to-be-released book will undoubtedly change his story as you know it. Wake up to the world's best-kept secrets will truly enlighten or re-educate the so-called African Americans and Black descendants of slaves scattered all around the world. To read this eye-opening first chapter, please visit SeventhDayPublishing.com.
Brought to you by
on the May We Help You Radio Network.
Only on the May We Help You Radio Network.
Only on the May We Help You Radio Network.
Only on the May We Help You Radio Network.
Only on the May We Help You Radio Network.
Only on May We Help You Radio Network.
So on the May We Help You Radio Network.
MWHY Radio Network.
May We Help You Radio.
On the May We Help You Radio Network.
Only on the May We Help You Radio Broadcast Network, the network that helps you.
Well, welcome back, everyone. Welcome back. We are still here with the Happily Married Wives Radio Broadcast. I am Latisha M.
And I am Louidajean L.J. Holloway Payton.
I'm telling you, girl, you got like one of the longest names in the business. In the business. But we're your hosts for tonight. And, you know, if you guys are just tuning in, you did miss a couple of great segments. We just came out of Step Right Up. Louidajean poured so much into us. You know, she took us back to who we were previously and recognizing, you know, the urgency for change and then the need for wanting to be more for somebody who you don't even realize you're doing it for. I loved your segment. First off, you're such a great storyteller. I was in that club with you, all right? I was on that phone call with you when you were talking to your mother. I was shopping with you and your sister for, you know, her wedding dress and getting her set up because, it, you know, you were able to tell it from such a real-life perspective. The things that I really did enjoy about your time and on the program today, one thing that you said, your mother said, after you talked to your mother, you realized you needed to live like I never lived before. That was I think that was the first step that you took, you know, because before you was still just on the platform.
Right, yeah.
And
yeah.
That was the, you know, just living your life, satisfying your immediate needs. You weren't even thinking of any long-term situation. You was just thinking about your immediate needs. And when you said, live like I never lived before, that was the first thing that you then started really paying attention to everything that was going on around you.
Yeah.
And what
definitely
it was.
So.
You know, and then you said, you know, that women in particular need to have that your defining moment. When did you realize that what type of person you wanted to be? Not even put in an equation the type of person you want to be with. Because like you said, we could all have our list. I know some women that have freaking 3 pages of a list. I mean, these men now, in order to date some people, I know you got to come with your credit check in hand. You know what I mean? Like,
come on now, keep it real, I got you.
You know, but it's like, you know, but you sitting here trying to criteria every man who steps up to you. Criteria, you got to love the fact that I made up a word there.
But you haven't even
defined who you are going to be in that person's life.
Come on.
Louidajean. You know I like calling you LJ, but when I have to say something serious, I'd be like, Louidajean. Because I'm telling you. You know, and then I think the last thing that really stuck with me, And it shows the person who you are now. It shows all the steps that you take. And it doesn't mean that you still don't have room for growth. But it shows all the steps that you took. You said that you have a servant mindset. When you are willing to be subservient and willing to pour in what you know, what you have, your hands, your hard work, your back, your mind, whatever it is, to others, the blessings will always come for you. You may go through hard times. You may have it great and good right now. But when you're living on God, what am I doing today?
Yeah.
How am I blessing somebody today? Where are my hands supposed to be today? It changes everything.
Yeah. Yeah.
And I love the fact that that was one of your step up moments, that you really looked at how, as a Christian now, because like you said, you wasn't always living a Christian lifestyle, but now as a Christian now, what am I supposed to do? And that was your new mindset. So, you know, I'm just so thankful that you shared that with us.
Ah, thank you. To God be glory. You know, Latisha, you know, you share with us about the runaway bride, and what kept getting stuck in my mind was shedding that emotional cloak.
Yeah.
Come on now. Yeah. And, you know, how many of us out there just cloaking? I mean, we're so good at it. We like Star Trek, you know, Star Wars. We can hit the button, right? Boom. And it just goes in and out. Then can't nobody even tell when they next to you. Your homie, your homegirl, your mama came in. You know, they ask me questions like, baby, you all right? And you faking a funk, right?
Mm-hmm.
So that was just so powerful, you know, and so I know that we're going to have some people that's going to have to start putting down the button, putting down, because, you know, there's a step, there's a process, and I don't recommend that nobody just shed the cloak immediately,
yeah.
Unless you want to go into withdrawal like a crack
that's
addict.
That's a walk,
come on now.
Exactly.
That's a walk. And so that was just so powerful. To put it in a term that everybody can relate to, regardless of your age, right? Where you are, female, male, it doesn't matter. But that's just pivotal in that. And then when you gave us those pointers, and I just love to, you know, Latisha, if you could just recap on those pointers. But the four points, right?
Yeah.
What makes you different? Right? Why does he or she need the light in the first place? Well, come on now.
Mm-hmm. And I think that's a defining moment. That's also goes into your step right up. What makes
definitely.
You different? I love that. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, definitely. And then you talked about, you know, what do you do for your sanity? Right? Mm-hmm. So even for you all that are married, if you're not taking that, you know, Latisha hit on it. If you're not taking a little bit of time, just a little bit, and some of us don't even respect, I mean, you know, I don't have to go to the beautician anymore unless I just want to, but let's keep it real, and this is for the men as well. When you go to the barbershop and the beauty shop, you know, that's a four-hour hiatus. Come on.
Mm-hmm.
Come on.
Mm-hmm.
And then you want to get mad because you're like, oh, well, I ain't been nowhere. I just went to go get my hair did. Really? Are you kidding me? Really? You
knowing you was there forever.
come on. So you got your little sanctuary time. You're just not taking advantage, right? Taking advantage. So I love the fact that you really made us think about that. And then you point based on the fact of, are you giving him enough space? Come on now, because you know it's some of us. We've got to bring it to you, right? And then all of a sudden, you just smother them like chicken.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And for those out there that's listening to that point that she just now said, and you're in denial, you know it's you.
You know it's you. Come on now. You know it's you. I mean, it's so funny. You know, the other day, one of my girls, she made this little comment about, well, you know, you don't know what's going on this phone and all that. I said, well, what? Why would I be thinking about that?
Yeah.
Right? Right? Don't let Satan be bringing thoughts up to you, and then you start speaking it to the enemy. Because come on now, you there's power, right? There's life and death in the power of the tongue, and then you're gonna speak something to some atmosphere.
Mm-hmm.
On behalf of some foolishness, because you don't want to give somebody some space.
Mm-hmm.
Really?
We all need our space. We all need to think.
Come on now. Come on now. We all need to think. And then your last thing you really point based and just kind of took me there was, you know, planning some time together. Come on now. And I got, you know, as I mentioned, I got probably different time periods in my life with my husband, you know, on how we actually did that. But I love, Latisha, how you shared about that planning time together, because a lot of us, we think because we're with the kids, come on, let's keep it real, right? Or because we had a family gathering, or because we go to church together. You know,
that is
because,
not planned time.
On.
That and you know what's important about that, because when the kids are not home, what is your life going to look like when they're not there? You already have to incorporate that couple time, because if it wasn't for your union, it wouldn't have been no kids, whether it
come
was with
now.
This husband or not. But y'all are raising them together. So that, to me, that is important, and about, you know, not losing your identity, because it's about your identity, but it's also the identity as your union. You can't
lose
it.
Yeah, definitely so. Definitely so. So I'm so excited. I just want y'all to know, I can't wait till I listen back.
I'm telling you, you know, and people don't understand, like, I keep talking about the premiere show, but also Lisa and Lisa went before us. It's a couple of people who went before us. You definitely want to go back and listen, because if you didn't take notes the first time, it, you know, you don't know, you may recognize something that your sister is going through, that your cousin is going through, that you didn't realize what it was. You just thought it was some mess, but then to hear someone else's testimony and how they got over can better help you be that support system for someone else. So, Louidajean, I am super excited about this show. You know, everyone, we shared with you what we learned, but we want you to share with us what you learned. So I know I keep saying this, but we want you to follow us on Facebook. We are Happily Married Wife on Facebook. We are on Twitter, Happily Married W, because wives was too long. Or you can even visit us at happilymarriedwives.com. And on the radio show page, you can leave us a comment. You can even see what we look like on the Who We Are page. And we have a blog there, too. And every Monday in the morning, the new blog releases, where we are giving you tips. We're pouring into you. We're singing to you. We're not singing to you, but maybe we're but we're just loving you up in the blog. And so we want you to also read our blog, and you can share and comment on the blog right there from the website. You know, so it's some great things that you can do, and you can share it with someone who you want to be a happily married wife as well. Now, the last thing I know is, LJ, I know after this, after your one, the roller coaster, and now you getting them to step right up this program to take that roller coaster ride you was talking about before, the ups and downs, the loops. So if they want to connect with you outside of this broadcast, how can they do that?
Oh, definitely so. Well, you can send me an email, happilymarriedlj@gmail.com. I'm also on Facebook, but you got to know how to spell my name. So I'd like to go out to Happily Married Live, get that name spelling down. But
copy-paste, baby, copy-paste.
But the Facebook page is Louidajean LJ Payton. And then I'm also on Twitter, and so my Twitter is Happily M and then wife, WIFE. And so I'm excited. Hit me up however you can. You can get me. You can get me.
I love it. Well, I know I can be reached a lot of different ways, but let's just make it easy, guys. Visit me at the website, the Happily Married Wives website. All of that stuff comes to me first.
Yeah.
I distribute it out.
Thank you.
There you go. Or on Twitter at Happily Married W. You can also follow the network, because we have, like I said, a lot of shows. This is one of the great shows that's new to the network, but MWHY Radio. So we're MWHY Radio on Twitter. We're May We Help You Radio, or MWHY Radio on Facebook. And I can be emailed directly at MWHYLLC@gmail.com. So, you know, I know that this has been just a great moment for us, and you know, guys are going to be screaming, I got to hear from LJ and Latisha again. So, you know, we'll be coming back soon. Stay to hold your horses, or you can go on the site, read our blogs, listen to LJ. She gave a great recorded submission, so you can even listen to LJ But, you know, for this week, we just want you to tune in next week, same time, 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time on Mondays. And
yes.
This upcoming Monday after us, we have the amazing Janika and Shamika. I know. Janika and Shamika. It is a mouthful, but let me tell you, J and S is going to pour into you. So
yes,
that's
they are.
Coming
Come
up December 14th. So, guys, don't miss that show. But right now, we're going to say goodnight. So, LJ, take it out.
All right. Good night, ladies and gentlemen.
Kisses, everybody. Stay tuned.
We hope you enjoyed this episode of the Happily Married Wives radio broadcast. I know that Louidajean Payton and myself, Latisha M., gave you some food for thought on transforming your life without changing who you are. Let us know what you think about the show by visiting us online at happilymarriedwives.com. You can also like us on Facebook at Happily Married Wife and follow us on Twitter at Happily Married W. We can't wait to see you next week here on the Happily Married Wives broadcast.